Emojis are exceptionally useful because they help provide tone and intent in forms of communication where otherwise that can be completely misconstrued, such as anywhere on the internet, email, and the dreaded text. They can also act as a sort of shorthand communication, expressing larger concepts with one or two tiny pictorial blocks. They're also just really cute. Like, I mean, how can you not look at the smiling cat and be like, ah, that's great. I just want those throughout my day. Emojis are actually bits of Unicode. That's how they appear universally throughout all your digital applications. That's also why there are digital emoji keyboards across your devices as well. On your phones, you have the emoji keyboard tray. On Windows, emojis are available on the touch keyboard input. And also on macOS, you have that touch bar thing. You can press them. Unicode, just keeping the world together. So I'd always wanted to build a physical HID keyboard specifically for sending emojis. It's been a goal for literally years. I mentioned it in one of my very first ever videos, like one of the first five, I think. And then I also mentioned it, and I have this older video on like making a macro keyboard with Arduino. Mentioned it there too. Not that I'm advocating for digging up old videos of mine because they make me cringe. I'd say my videos have maybe a 4 to 6 month lifespan, actually, before they make me cringe. Yeah, I don't know why I do this. Anyway, yeah, always wanted to make an emoji HID keyboard. I looked into how to send like Unicode directly. The Unicode emoji strings are actually a little bit longer, so they don't really play that well with a lot of the decoders. I looked into maybe how to access the Windows Touch keyboard directly. No, and I wanted it to be like Arduino or CircuitPython based. I wanted it to be like a DIY solution. I didn't want to go into I didn't want to have another app running on the computer to send it. I wanted it to be like living within the devices. Firmware, so that's why I didn't go into like hotkeys. But then, finally, the Windows pop-out menu for sending emojis entered the chat. You access it by pressing Windows key period on your keyboard, makes this little like menu pop out. Then you can like click around or search around for your ideal emoji that you need to send in that moment. When this became a thing, I did like a quick experiment one night with CircuitPython where I was like sending arrow keys and I was kind of like searching around and I was able to like send an emoji, but it still didn't feel quite right. So it was still lacking something. And then there was a pandemic followed by this macro keyboard explosion after the RP2040. Was released. Everyone was making macro keyboards. That's all everyone was talking about. And so at that point, it felt like it was right to go back into the emoji macro keyboard fever dream. Using CircuitPython, I used a combination of navigation keys and search queries to bring up and send specific emojis. Now, I didn't want this to just be for Windows. I also want to do a macOS version. Luckily, macOS has a very similar method for having a pop-up emoji menu. So just by changing up the keyboard combo, it was pretty easy to adapt the code. I'm using an Adafruit 1x4 Neo keyboard along with a QtPie RP2040. The Neo keyboard communicates over I2C to send the button presses, but like you can do any button input for this and just like adapt the code accordingly. You don't even need to use keyboard keys, although personally for me, aesthetically and tactilely, keyboard keys are just very pleasing. So any chance I have to use them, I'm gonna use them. Nairuz designed up this lovely, lovely case for it, and we worked together on a learn guide for Adafruit, which I will link down below. You can download the code, the files, and build your own. Also makes a really effective fidget toy. So, I mean, at that point, who cares about emojis? Just play with this. I'm glad I finally got to build an emoji HID keyboard. In the future, I'd love to build a larger one. I feel like I say that at the end of every project. I'd like to either build a larger or smaller version of the thing I just did. With the emoji keyboard, though, I think it'd be cool if you were able to query like emojis on the fly, so you weren't like hard coding which emojis were attached to each key. So you could technically, in theory, like send any emoji you wanted at any time. But until then, you know, I mean, four of my favorite emojis, that's respectable, that's nice. I'm okay with four. Four is fine, it's a nice number. I'm at peace with four emojis. I'm not going to think about the fact that there's literally hundreds of other emojis. Four is fine. I should be fine with four. Okay, well anyway, that's going to do it for this video. This has been Blitz City DIY. I'll just be thinking about all the other emojis that could be on this keyboard.